So good morning. Only 20 students have joined. So far, stack and queue are clear. What is stack and what are the applications of stack? So far, clear or any doubt? Okay, so far clear. Any doubts? Please write a message in chat box. So what is stack? Stack is a data structure where the elements are inserted at one end, deletion at the other end. Different types of operations of stack are push and pop. Okay, and the stack has to insert the element to stack will call it as push, and to delete an operation from the stack will call it as pop operation. And what are the applications of stack are conversion of expressions. I already explained in which to postfix, postfix to prefix, prefix to infix. And then another application of stack is the conversion of expressions. Evaluation of expression. By using postfix and prefix, you can evaluate the expression into a single value by using stack. Then another applications of stack is recursion. I already explained the towers of any problem. So in exam point of view, applications of stack, you write these three topics. One is recursion and conversion of expressions, and another one is evaluation of expression. Now we move to the queue. So see here, queue is a data structure. But here, queue is a data structure where the elements are inserted at one end and deletion at other end. In stack, elements are inserted at one end and deleted at the same end. But here, inserted one end, deleted other end. So, somewhat similar to stack, but here queue is opened at both ends. So, insertion one end, deletion at other end. Okay, one end is always used to insert the data, we call it as end queue. Okay, and the other is used to remove data, we call it as DQ. End queue means insert the data, DQ means delete in queue, end queue means insert the data. So the queue is also called as first in first out data structure. So who inserted first, he will remove first. So just see here one way. See this diagram, queue can mean seeing one way road. So where the vehicle enter first, exit first. And also another example for is ticket windows. When we go to movie, so we stay in line, stay in a queue. So that is also another example of queue. So queue representation. So queue is represented in this way. This is of one array. So insertion at one end, deletion at the other end. So see here, this is first in, first out. So this is my friend direction. From this side, I remove the data. I insert from here. This is N queue and this is D queue. Okay, clear. So see the diagram here. So here NQ means insert an element into the insert the element at the rear end means back side, and delete an element and return the same from the front end. Okay. And empty queue is there and the full is there. We will discuss later. First, you have to see how queue. See here, this is the queue. We are using just like stack, we are using here also queue, we are using array, just to use it as a stack. In this also using array. So here in this insertion deletion at front end and insertion at rear end. So this we call it as rear and this we call it as front. For example, here we are using the in stack we are using push and pop. Here we are using rear and front. The words here we are using is rear and front. Okay, initially so initially rear equal to minus one, front equal to minus one here. So initial conditions for rear means insertion at the back end, front means deletion at front end. So insertion at one end, deletion at other end. So first you want to insert, for example, if you want to insert an element into the stack, you use the operation called as rear. So rear is here, default we are taking, initially we are taking as rear equal to minus one. So you just, before inserting the element into queue, you just write here plus plus pre-increment rear. Why we are using pre-increment means initially rear is minus one. So the element's insertion starts from zero onwards. So that's why we pre-increment the rear. So here now rear equal to zero. So now you can insert at 0th position the element 7. So now we insert the 7. Again rear increment by 1, then you can insert. Okay, again rear is incremented by 1 and you can insert, and now rear position is 4. So it has capability to store the 2 elements extra, and you can store or you can stop here. Okay. Okay, so now I want to delete the element from queue. So if you want to delete the element from queue, you just directly pre-increment front and delete. Okay, so just you write queue of plus plus front. So delete 7, now 7 is deleted. Now front value is 0. And now again front incremented by 1, then 1, 8 is deleted and front is incremented by 1, 9 is deleted. See here, rear is 4 here, front is, after deleting, front is 3. Okay. So front is 3, now here rear is 4. If you want to insert, you can insert at rear end. Now I have insert the element is 12 here. So if you want to delete, the element 10 is deleted first. Okay, just here concept is insertion at one end, deletion at other end. Okay, so you can insert from this side, delete from front end. So initially here we have two variables name as front and rear. Rear is used for inserting element in the queue and front is used for deleting element into the queue. Just like stack, if rear equal to queue size minus one, you already studied in stack. If rear equal to equal to queue size minus 1, queue is overflow. Okay, if rear equal to equal to rear equal to equal to queue size minus 1, queue size minus 1. Why? Because here the array size is 7. Okay, the queue I am taking here, queue as 7, and the rear starts from, array starts from 0 to 1. Now I insert that element, next I insert 12, then 13. Now queue, the rear and rear value is here, 6 now. Okay, rear is 6 here. So 6 equal to queue size is 7, 7 minus 1, 6. It indicates queue is overflow. rare equal to minus 1. So rare equal to minus 1. So here rare is 6 and q is minus 1, 6. So q is full. Okay. So what is the what is the overflow condition? What is the empty condition? So basic operations are NQ. I already told you DQ is removed, and so peak. Another operation is peak means get the element at the front end of the queue without removing it. Just to read the front element without removing it, we call it as a peak. So is full. Check if the queue is full. Is empty. Queue is empty for full condition. Just I am saying is full. What is the if rear equals to max size minus 1. Okay, if rare equal to just we see the program, don't worry. Max size minus 1, true means returns it indicates the queue is full. Okay, see here, if rare equal to max size minus 1, returns true, else false. So in this way, we have to represent if queue is empty, if the the front is less than is greater than rare. Okay, if the front is, that is f greater than r, that means q is empty. See, so this is the condition. If f less than zero or front greater than rare, so q is empty. Clear? So we see the empty condition in programming. Then Q operations. If you want to insert, first you have to check if the Q is full or not. If Q is full, proceed overflow. Okay. If the Q is full, you do not insert any item. So it print a message Q is full. If Q is not full, increment rare by 1. So then if you increment by 1, then we add the element into the queue because we inserted rare end only. So see here, I am in this example, say he draws rare here, front here. So I insert A, insert B, insert C by incrementing A. Next I insert D. Is it clear? So far clear students, are any doubt? So far clear, are any doubts? Write a message in chat box. Clear, students, waiting for your reply. So you can insert here. Okay, next you can remove elements. Okay, so insert logic is, so algorithm is procedure Q. NQ means inserted front end. This Q is full, return overflow, and if this is algorithm, otherwise rare is incremented by 1. Okay, so rare equal to rare plus 1, and q equal to data will be stored in the rare, that is q. Rare is nothing but the position of the q. In that way you can store the data. So the data will be stored in the q, and increment again will be stored until it gets false, means q is full. Next, you move to the DQ operation. So delete operation, when you want to delete the element, first you have to check the Q is empty or not. So if f greater than r, Q is empty. F square the null, Q is empty. So if the Q is empty, proceed print a message that Q is underflow. Otherwise, increment Q by 1. Okay, then delete one by one element from the queue. So see the diagram here. So these are the elements I inserted. So first I insert A from where end and B and C and D. Now I want to delete the element front increment front by one, then delete A. So first element is A, that will insert deleted first, then B, then C, then D, then it print a message Q is empty. So this is the algorithm, Q is empty, return. Otherwise, data equal to Q of empty. Why we are taking here data element, the delete element will be displayed on the screen. That purpose I'm using here data. So front is yes, A is stored in data. The delete element will be slow as, will be shown as A. Then front equal to front plus one. Okay, clear. So far clear, no one send a message, reply message. Anyone respond? Is it audible? Anyone write a message? Is it clear? Can I move forward to another topic? So just we see one program for Q. So see here, this is the program for Q. Already told you this is the header file, and if you declare the size there before starting the program, so yeah, just like Q, just like stack, start the program. We initialize the queue size before starting our program by using the hash define. Okay, this is a it will allocate memory for the queue. We use the keyword called as define, hash define. Then I am taking, so I am taking two variables. So next I am taking the item. Which the item I am going to insert, then I will take the queue size as 5. And see here, I am taking here f equal to 0 and r equal to minus 1. Why? Because you directly delete the element from Q by using Q plus plus. So f value is 0, 0 element is. So this is the condition I am taking, f equal to 0 and r equal to minus 1. Previously I told R equal to minus 1 and Q front equal to minus 1. So in this case, in this way also you can represent. Just remember that F equal to 0 and R equal to minus 1. If F equal to R equal, F equal to minus 1, you can pre increment F by 1. So in this program, I'm taking F equal to 0 and R equal to minus 1. So R is pre incremented and F is post incremented. Okay, so far clear. So here we are using one switch case, because we have to perform either push, either insert or delete or display. So any one operation you can perform at a time. So for this purpose, we are using switch case here. Here I am using switch case here. I am taking variable name as ch and print the print enter the choice and scan of choice you have to choose. We have three choices are there. If you choose another choice 4, default it will exit of the loop. Okay, so this is my program main int character. This is the int ch main choice. Okay, I am taking here infinite loop here because so many times we have to choose only one option, either insert or delete. So multiple choice server have to choose anyone. So for this, every time it will ask the choice, either case one or case two, or insert or delete or display. So continuously it will display ask your choice. For that purpose, I am taking here infinite loop. That is for two semicolons. It is an infinite loop. So case one is insert the elements. So if you want to insert the element, you through user's requirement. For that purpose, I am using the scanf function. So what you want to insert, you can insert into the stack by using the input function, that is scanf percentage item. Item is nothing but the inserting element will be stored in item. Then enter the item and insert into the queue. So I insert, I am then I call the function insert where. Okay, so when I call the function insert where, first it will check the queue is full or not. So I am taking a where as r and front as f. So if r equal to queue size minus 1, that is overflow, queue is overflow. The condition is false, then increment r by 1. So here r equal to r plus 1. Or you can write here directly plus plus r. Then item will be stored into the queue. Next, see here, delete friend. I call the function delete friend. So if you want to delete the item, first you have to check the condition. If queue is empty, if the queue is empty, you cannot delete any items from the queue. So that's why f greater than r, why? Because f equal to 0, r equal to minus 1 is initial condition. If f greater than r means queue is empty or underflow. So if the condition falls, then queue of f plus plus. So f means front end, it will delete first element, then increment by 1. Okay, so this is the condition after deletion overall process. Okay, overall deletion, and finally you initialize the initial condition of the queue, that is f equal to 0 and minus equal to 1. So why we are doing this means, why we are writing this code here means, why we are writing this means, if the queue has A, B, C, okay. This is rare, this is friend. So if you delete A, deleted. Next B, deleted. Next C, deleted. So the items all are deleted. Now queue is empty. So any queue is empty means what is the initial condition? F equal to 0 and R equal to minus 1. Here f value is 3, sorry, 0, 1, 2. Here f equal to 2. Okay. And r is initially 2. Okay. Whenever you delete the value, so f, then the condition is f greater than r. So f greater than r. So the initial value have to store, that is f equal to 0, r equal to minus 1 means you delete all the elements into the queue. The queue is now empty. For this purpose, you use this code here. Next, see for display. So display also, if you check the queue is empty or not, for this purpose, I use if f greater than r, queue is empty and return. Otherwise, I'm taking for loop one. So I'm taking here I equal to f or I equal to 0, I less than q minus 1, I plus plus. Okay, you can take any one. I equal to f or I equal to 0 means f equal to 0 initially I represent. So I take here I equal to f. So why I am taking t means if you here taking if you another why we are taking another variable means if you want to delete print the statement f is used for delete. So I initialize this to t. So now use this function q equal to t plus plan. So the elements in the queue are deleted one by one. Please display it in one by one. Okay, just we run this program, we may check if its program is correct or not. Okay, just I run the program here. Okay, enter the choice here. We have three choices, 1, 2, 3. So initially I want to insert the element into the queue. So I want to enter the choice 1, that is enter the item. I want to insert the item is 10. Now enter. Again you ask the choice. Again I want to insert the item 1. So that is 20. Again I want to insert the item 1. That is 30. Here queue size is 5, means it will, it has the ability to store only 5 elements. 140, 150, 160. Here only 5 elements transfer, Q is overflow. Okay, now I want to display the elements. Here I insert 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So now I want to delete the element in the queue. Press the operation called 2. So 10 is deleted. So see here, delete item is 10, enter the choice. Again, I delete the element, then 20 will be deleted, next 30 will be deleted, next 40 will be deleted, next 50 will be deleted. Next, see here, queue is empty. Okay, queue is underflow. See here. So, in this way, you perform operations on queue. Here queue is underflow. Okay, this is the program. So far clear, students. No one sent reply message. Is it clear? So just I unmute. I give permission to you if anybody wants to raise your hand or write a message in chat box. So far clear. Okay, so for clear students. So this is about Q. So what is Q? Just I am defining the Q. So Q is a data structure where the elements are inserted at one end and deletion at the other end. Okay. So for inserting the element, we call it as rear end, and delete the element, we call it as front end. Okay. So Q is also called as first in, first out data structure. Okay. So okay, first in, first out data structure. So if the queue is full, that is nothing but rear equal to queue size minus 1. If queue is empty, that is F greater than R, queue is empty. Okay. Clear, students? Clear? Anyone write it, send a reply message. Okay, so this is about Q. Next we have different types of Qs are there. Okay, so before going just I am sharing another one. So different types of Q operations are there. One is different types of Qs are there. One is circular Q, another one is double-ended Q. So so what is a circular Q? Before moving to the circular Q, so first we have to know why they implemented circular Q. Means in Q, see here, see the diagram here. This is the Q. Where is from where starts here and end here. So see here, this is Q, that is starts with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now R equal to how much? R equal to 6 now. Okay. And F equal to 0. So if we delete the elements in the Q, okay. So I now delete that 21, I deleted, 33 I deleted. Okay. Now and 4 is also deleted. Now what is the Q value? What is the F value here? F equal to 2 here. Now F equal to 2 and R equal to 6. Okay. So here these blocks are empty now. So if you want to insert the element, where we can insert the element? From this side, rear end. Okay. Actually, R value is 6. Okay. So R value is 6, Q size is 7. So you want to insert. So 6 equal to 6 minus 1. That is 6. So it shows power flow condition. But here, there is empty is there, but it shows the here empty space is there. 0, 1, 2 are empty, but it shows the power flow condition. Okay. So in linear queue, once the queue is completely full, it is not possible to insert more elements. Even if you dequeue the queue to remove some of the elements, already removed these three elements, until the queue is reset, no new elements are to be inserted. Okay. So for this purpose, we are using circular queue. So here, when dequeue an element to remove it from the queue, So I remove two elements. So the we are actually moving the front end of the queue. So here front end deleted. Now the queue, we cannot insert new element because rare point is still at the rare. So rare point is at sixth position. So we cannot insert the queue. If you want to insert the element into the queue, you just refresh or delete all the elements in the queue, and then again you can insert. So in this case, if the two blocks of memory is empty in queue, but rare is at position 6, it shows that queue is overflow. So in this way, if the queue is empty also, we cannot insert the element. So this is the disadvantage of queue. So to overcome this disadvantage, we use another operation called another queue called, that is, we call it as a circular queue. So just circular queue means you can represent the queue in circular way. That is also using array, but in pictorial representation, we represent the queue in circular way. See here. So circular queue is as a linear structure. So it is also follows the first in, first out. Here the circular queue means that rear end is connected to the front end. We call it as a circular queue. See here. The rear end is connected to the front end. This is the circular queue. So the pictorial representation of circular queue, see here. See here, in this head pointer will always point to the front end of the queue, and tail pointer will also always point to the end of the queue. Tail means rear end, head means front end. Here front end and rear point at same position. Okay, so that is here head equal to 0 and r equal to minus 1. F equal to 0 and r equal to minus 1. So here data is always added to the location pointed by the tile. In same properties we are using in queue, that is insertion at rear end, deletion at front end. Here in this diagram, rear end is tile, front end is head. You can insert the elements into the queue by using the tile only. Okay, by using tile only, you can insert and you can delete the element by using head only. Similarly, you can increment tile by 1 by inserting the elements. See here, I am inserting D1, then insert again D2, D3 by incrementing the tile. Okay, I insert D1, D2, D3, D4. So far clear, students? Anyone responds? Anyone respond? Just unmute yourself and is it clear so far? Students, if you send a reply message, then I can understand is it clear or not. Is it clear? Anyone send a reply message? So this is a circular queue. So the front end is connected to the rear end. We call it as a circular queue. So what are the disadvantages of this circular queue is, in queue, if you delete some elements in the front end, again, you want to insert the elements. resource, okay, resource queue is empty. So in circular queue, if you delete the element from the queue, you can insert, if the queue is full, you can insert the elements at the end. See here, this diagram, I insert all the elements. Now the queue is full here. I already inserted D1, D2 and so on. Till now D8 I inserted. So just I delete tile, means D1 is deleted. Okay, now see here, I remove three elements in this. So I want to insert that the queue is empty. Now I can insert the, see here, D8, now I can insert D9, D10. See clearly, see the diagram. So I insert D8, then I remove D1 and D2, D3, D4, D5. Total four elements are deleted by using head. Then I increment tile by one, I insert two elements here. Now after that, D9 is inserted and D10 is inserted. But this type is this type of insertion is not possible in queue. So that's why I am using here circular queue. So this is the reason. So how we can insert here D9, D10? How it is possible? Okay. So tomorrow we will discuss the small logic, how we insert before the elements is empty. If the queue is empty, how you insert the elements in the front end. Tomorrow we will discuss the this front end, how we insert the elements in the front end in circular queue, and also we see one program about the circular queue. So no one send a reply message. Is it clear or not? Are you listening my class or not? I can't understand. If anyone hearing my class, just send a reply message. No one gives and no one send a message. Just you are not listening my class. Okay, today I end the session. Tomorrow we will meet. Thank you.